I'm Laura Pfeifer. I'm a PhD student over at Northeastern University in the College of Computer and Information Science.
My research, what I'm studying, is I really am interested in computer interfaces that are specifically designed for patients. So my goal when I joined the PhD program was one thing, and I wanted to help people. I'm like, I just want to help people. People need help, and I know I can do something. And specifically, I really want to help people in need. So there are a lot of people out there who don't have access to all of the stuff that I do, and I want to help them in any way that I can. So a lot of my time is split between, that's my office in computer science, and that's Boston Medical Center.
So today I gave a talk to the girls about technology in the field of healthcare, which is a really fascinating field for me. It's not something that I've been originally trained in, but it's a huge field, and it's one that needs, you know, has the opportunity for a lot of technological improvements. So hopefully I got the girls thinking about that and a career in technology and what they could bring to the picture.
My first job when I got to Northeastern, which was about 4.5 years ago, was to start creating a virtual nurse. Like, what? And this was a project that we had going on over at Boston Medical Center, where they wanted to help streamline their discharge process. And they wanted a virtual person to be able to teach the discharge instructions to people before they left the hospital. So we spent a ton of time observing. This is an actual nurse who worked at Boston Medical Center. And this is a little discharge booklet that they give patients. And we followed them around for months, researching what they were doing, how they would explain this document, when they would point to things, when they would circle things with their hand, what gestures they used, what verbal cues they would use to talk to patients. And we wanted to go from something like this to something that looked like this. It looked like a person. It could use all the same verbal and nonverbal cues to talk to patients before they left the hospital. So about 2 years after that started, we have a mobile cart that wheels up to the patient's bedside. And it's not really a nurse. I'll tell you a dirty little secret. It's not really a virtual nurse. It can't care for patients in the same way we think of nursing. It can't give them medications. It can't even hold their hand or do anything like that. But it can teach them a lot of stuff. And it can explain things in a very slow and nice and easy way. So this nurse uses a voice, so it can talk to them. And it can use nonverbal gestures, just like us humans do when we point out things to people. So I talked to a lot of patients about this. I was really concerned that patients were going to freak out and say, where is my doctor? I really want to talk to my doctor, not the stupid computer. And much to my surprise, they loved it. Really loved it. And they really liked that in a hectic healthcare environment like the hospital ward, they could have this really personalized time. They could take as much time as they needed to go over things again and again. They didn't feel stupid asking questions because they knew it was just a dumb computer. It wasn't going to be harsh on them if they didn't understand something. So that was really, really encouraging for me. And then the really exciting thing was that this technology actually went to Washington, D.C. on a little tablet computer. And this woman in blue, her name's Carolyn Clancy, and she's the head of all research at the Healthcare Research and Ambulatory Safety and Quality Division of the National Institutes of Health. And this woman in red, you might recognize her, she's the Secretary of Health and Human Services. So this was really fun for me to be able to show this to people in Washington, look at the research that I was working on, and have something really get out there and really make a difference.
If you can say that you help someone just make their life even a little bit better, it's great. It's what motivates me, it's what drives me, it's what keeps me up at night. So it's been a great experience.
Exactly how much can the virtual nurse do?
So her main goal is to explain this booklet that's given to patients. They're given a really personalized booklet before they go home. And the vast majority of what she does is explains their medications that they were prescribed. So a lot of the patients, I was really surprised, but some patients that leave the hospital are on over 30 different medications. It's really complicated to remember them and know what they all do and how they work and what you have to look out for. So she can explain over 6,000 different medications and several different conditions that a person might have, the reason why they were in the hospital. So anyone could come in and talk to it and go over their discharge procedures. That's what she primarily does.
Hi, I'm Morgan. I'm from Assabet Valley. I was wondering, because I go to a technical school, do you see the virtual nurse being in the nursing program for teaching the students how to work with it? And do you see in the future actual nursing being like the job just disappearing because the technology became so advanced that they actually had the nurses not needed? Like they could think the same way as a human nurse?
For your last question, I doubt it. I really, really doubt it. So there's a lot of things that technology can do to help the nurses. So when I talk to nurses over at Boston Medical Center, a lot of them really wish that they could spend an hour of time with each patient before they go home, but they just can't because they don't have the amount of resources and time. And this allows them to know that that's getting explained, and they can work on other things, like making sure that their medications are being dispensed properly and everything's working with their heart and all of these things that computers just cannot do yet, and it's going to be a really long time before they can. So there are programs right now that do work with doctors and nurses. So if you're a medical student and you're getting trained on how to be a doctor and how to interact with patients, we have virtual humans that will pretend to be a patient. They'll walk in and say, oh, my stomach hurts, I'm not feeling very good. And the doctor is in charge of, or the medical student is then learning how to diagnose the problem with these virtual humans.
Hi, my name is Leisha. I'm from the Horace Mann School for the Deaf. In terms of the virtual nurse programming, I'm interested in how it works. And you said it works with speech. I'm curious about your thinking about how it works with deaf patients who can't hear.
So I was just at a conference in Philadelphia. And these are a group of people who are working on virtual humans. And in particular, there's a group in France who's working on automated signing and virtual humans who can take in this case, it was the French language as input, just text. You type in something in French, and then the output would be a virtual human who was signing and signing accurately in French sign language with the correct gestures and hand movements. And it's a really tricky artificial intelligence problem. We humans are really good at being able to work with language and emotion and incorporate everything properly, but it's not just as easy as typing it into a computer and having it work. So it's a really hard problem, and a lot of people are very, very interested in solving it.
You know, I say go for it. I mean, I say anything that they want to do or try, just not to be scared. I know it can seem really intimidating, it can look really scary, it's this box that does magical things and it can be hard to understand, but it's really not scary. Anybody can do it, and it opens up such a huge variety of opportunities for girls. You can really apply those skills in any sort of field, whether it's, you know, theoretical computing or whether it's ocean sciences. So much can be done with a degree in computer science.